Violence against women has been acknowledged by the United Nations as one major issue of human rights. The establishment of the Special Rapporteur on Violence Against Women, its cause and consequences in the 1994 is an indication to it. Similarly, India also enacted a number of woman-specific legislations and woman-related legislations to check and minimize violence against women. However, violence against women continue to rise for a number of reasons. In the context of India, in general, the patriarchal and customary practices are the point of discussion. Whereas, in Manipur context, the existing armed conflict situation is a major concern for the violation of women rights. Defining civil and political rights. The Lincoln University of the Commonwealth of Pennsylvania, particularly the course on human rights issues in criminal justice, defined civil and political rights as the rights that generally restrict the power of the government in respect of actions affecting the individual and his or her autonomy and conferred an opportunity upon people to contribute to the determination of laws and participate in government. They are considered as the first generation rights. As per the United Nations, particularly the International Covenant on Civil and Political Rights, includes 1, right to life, 2, prohibition of torture, 3, the right to liberty and security of person, 4, the right to freedom of movement, 5, the right to a fair hearing, 6, the right to privacy, 7, the right to freedom of religion, expression, and peaceful assembly, 8, the right to family life, 9, the right of children to special protection, 10, the right to participate in the conduct of public affairs, 11, the overarching rights to equal treatment, and 12, the special rights of members of ethnic, religious, and linguistic minorities. These rights are also included in the Universal Declaration of Human Rights in different articles, such as Article 1 and 2, which deal with all individuals regardless of religion, creed, ethnicity, and sex. Article 3 to 19, which deal with rights related to individual life, liberty, and personal security. And Article 20 to 26, which deal with rights related to public and political participation. Civil and political rights under the Indian Constitution. The Indian Constitution incorporates these rights under the fundamental right, such as right to equality, which comprises Article 14, equality before law, Article 15, prohibition of discrimination on the ground of religion, race, caste, sex, or place of birth. Article 16, equality of opportunity in the matter of public employment. Article 17, abolition of untouchability. And Article 18, abolition of titles. Then right to freedom comprises Article 19, protection of certain rights regarding freedom of speeches. Article 20, protection in respect of conviction for offences. Article 21, protection of life and personal liberty. Article 22, protection against arrest and detention in certain cases. Rights against exploitation comprises Article 23, prohibition of traffic in human being and forced labor. Article 24, prohibition of employment of children in factories. Right to freedom of religion comprises Article 25, freedom of conscience and free profession, practice and propagation of religion. Article 26, freedom to manage religious affairs. Article 27, freedom as to payment of taxes for promotion of any particular religion. Article 28, freedom as to attendance at religious instruction or religious worship in certain educational institutions. Now, manifestation of violence against women. As per the Office of the United Nations Special Rapporteur on Violence Against Women, its cause and consequences, the violence against women are manifested in various forms, such as, number one, violence against women in the family, such as domestic violence, battering, marital rape, incest, forced prostitution by the family, violence against domestic workers and the girl child, non-spousal violence, violence related to exploitation, sex selective abortion and infanticide, traditional practices such as female genital mutilation, dowry related violence and religious customary laws. Number two, violence against women in the community, such as rape, sexual assault, sexual harassment, violence against women, migrant workers, and pornography. Number three, violence against women perpetrated or condoned by the state, such as gender-based violence within institutions, trafficking and forced prostitutions, armed conflict, custodial violence, violence against refugees and internally displaced persons, and violence against women from indigenous and minority groups. Number four, violence against women in the transnational spheres, which is due to globalization and increased transnational processes. Now, causes for violence against women. United Nations Convention on Elimination of All Forms of Discrimination Against Women, in short CEDAW, define gender-based violence as violence directed against a woman because she is a woman, or who is affect a woman disproportionately. It includes physical, mental, or sexual harm or suffering, threat of such act, coercion, and others, deprivation of liberty. A more comprehensive definition is given by the Declaration on Elimination of Violence Against Women, which defines violence against women to mean any act of gender-based violence that results in or is likely to result in physical, sexual, or psychological harm or suffering to women, including threat of such acts, coercion or arbitrary deprivation of liberty, whether occurring in public or private life. The causes of violation of women's rights are multiple. However, in order to understand the causes, there is a need to contextualize the analysis as tradition, culture, or customary laws. For instance, violence against women in India is systematic and occurs in public and private spheres. It is underpinned by the persistence of patriarchal social norms and inter and intra-gender hierarchies. Women are discriminated against and subordinate not only on the basis of sex, but on other grounds such as caste, class, ability, sexual orientation, tradition, and other realities. that exposes mainly to a continuum of violence throughout the life cycle, commonly referred to as existing from the womb to the tomb. The manifestation of violence against women are a reflection of the structural and institutional inequality that is a reality for most women in India. Rasida Manju, 2014. Some of the major causes for the violence against women in India are: number 1, patriarchal system; number 2, customary practices such as dowry, early and forced marriage, honor killing, and son preference; number 3, socioeconomic dependency of women to their husband and family members; number 4, sexual violence such as rape and sexual harassment. For instance, according to the National Crime Record Bureau, in 2012, 2.84 cases of rape were reported every hour. Number 5, lack of effective response to violence, such as effective implementation of women-related legislations and women-specific legislations. Number 6, armed conflict. Number 7, trafficking and migration. Number 8, the racial discrimination on the people from the Northeast, particularly women. Classification of violence against women. As per the Indian legal system, violence against women is broadly classified under two categories. That is, A, the crime under the Indian Penal Code, IPC, and B, the crime under the Special and Local Laws, SLL. Number A, the crime under the Indian Penal Code. Number 1, rape, Section 376 IPC. Rape cases has been further categorized as incest rape and other rape cases. Number 2, kidnapping and abduction, Section 363 to 373. Number 3, dowry debt, Section 302 and 304B, and Dowry Prohibition Act, 1961. Number 4, torture, cruelty by husband and relative, Section 498A of IPC. Number 5, molestation, Section 354 of IPC. Number 6, sexual harassment, Section 509 of IPC. Number 7, importation of girls, Section 366B of IPC. Number B, the crimes under the special and local laws. In that, number 1, the Immoral Traffic and Prevention Act, 1956. Number 2, the Dowry Prohibition Act, 1961. 28 of 1961, amended in 1986. Number 3, the Indecent Representation of Women Prohibition Act, 1986. Number 4, the Commission of Sati Prevention Act, 1987, 3 of 1988. Number 5, Protection of Women from Domestic Violence Act, 2005. Number 6, the Sexual Harassment of Women at the Workplace, Prevention, Prohibition and Redressal Act of 2013. Manipur context. Violence against women is cause and consequences in the context of Manipur should be correctly be viewed as violence against indigenous women. The major causes of violence against women in our region acquires dimensions that include torture, ill-treatment, other form of inhuman punishment and killing by national security forces and police personnel, officers of India in starting Proposition in the state of Manipur and Northeast region. Hui says, in a non-international armed conflict or war situation for the past 6 decades. Under the de jure and de facto impunity provided by the emergency military legislations applied to this region called the Armed Force Special Power Act 1958, the security forces violate the right to life and access to justice and remedy, it is said by Civil Society Coalition on Human Rights in Manipur and the UN in the year 2013. This does not mean that there is no other form of violence against women in Manipur. However, the conflict-related violence needs urgent attention. Conclusion. Violence against women is increasing in spite of the global effort to minimize the situation. Likewise, in spite of the various legislations which are specific to women's rights in India, the ineffective implementation has kept the effort insignificant. The increasing cases of racial discrimination, particularly against women, are yet to address. The government of India has to come up with an anti-racial law. Moreover, in the conflict region of India, particularly Manipur, armed conflict contributes the major causes for violence against women.